Ah, yes, my son. You have defeated the great Emperor Slither. I am most impressed.
It's my pleasure, O Sacred One.
However, there's one more quest needed to be fulfilled, young one.
Yes, anything.
Go to a lot of bakeries.
Well, Master, that sounds delicious.
I set out on my quest for bakeries in this odd enchanted civilization. There were lots of loud noises and big pieces of metal. Bumped into this Native American Indian. He said he'd look out for bakeries for me. Which is good, because I honestly had no idea where I was heading. I came across my first bakery. Everything looked real delicious. I asked the baker to whip me up a fresh one. Needless to say, my oat scone with raisins and walnuts was pretty dang scrumptious. Yum. Onward and outward, I was on to my next bakery. I asked the baker what his least favorite pastry was. I got that one. I don't know what his problem was, but my bomboloni with seasonal jam was exquisite to say the least. A quick subway journey brought me to my third bakery. I saw plenty of macaroons. I got chocolate. It tasted like ice cream. I was okay with this. It was at this point where I realized the adventures and danger that surround me in this foreign village. As noted from these brave men, at least I'm not battling this mechanical brontosaurus. I think they won. On to bakery number 4. I made my way to the entrance. I tried to befriend a bird. I failed. But that's understandable. I snatched myself an oatmeal raisin scone. The lady folk here were real lovely. Now that I think of it, this bakery was actually my favorite one yet. We're at home slice. After encountering a wild beast and yet another subway journey, the fifth bakery and I collided paths, notable for their cool floor patterns and wide variety of fresh bread. I found myself at peace while I indulged on this squash pizza. With my body energy flourishing thanks to the nutrients found in squash, I moved right along to the next bakery, where I made the easy choice of getting sweet potato pie. I ate that right up. I took a much needed rest, until I was back on my feet and right on into the bakery number 7. Yet again, everything looked very delicious. However, my stomach wasn't doing so well. I settled for a small sample. It was pretty good, but not nearly as good as the pretzel croissant I experienced at the next bakery. I destroyed it, and had absolutely no idea where to put the dirty plate. I kinda just had to put it somewhere, and run for the hills. With my conscience full of guilt, I paced myself to the next bakery. Oh man. Here I was, bakery number 9. I was eating a berry fruit tart until I realized I was beyond full. I was tired. My watch has been saying 12 o'clock for hours. I concluded up my trip. I'm sure this was the end of the quest. Even if it wasn't. I learned a lot from the adventure.
Around every corner, there's a good life and monsters and sugar. Oh, sugar.